Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the invocation by the battalion chaplain, Lieutenant Chris Martin.
Let us pray. Gracious Lord, we ask for your blessing upon this ceremony and all those who are present. As the command passes from Lieutenant Colonel Goff to Lieutenant Colonel Holt, may we be reminded of the responsibilities and opportunities of leadership, the commitment of sacrifice of those who serve this country, and those families who support them. Bless Lieutenant Colonel Goff, Carmen, and their family as he is directed to a new mission. Give to Lieutenant Colonel Holt wisdom, compassion, strength, and courage as he leads us in our training and into our next deployment. Keep the Marines and sailors of this battalion focused on the mission and safe in its execution. In God's holy name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. The adjutant for today's parade is First Lieutenant Lamberto Mathurin. Present-day parades in the Marine Corps have their bases in both history and tradition. The mass formation of troops on one long line at close interval made possible the massing of firepower for muzzle-loaded muskets of yesterday. In those early days, the line of battle was just that, a line of two or three ranks, and looked much like the parade formation you see today. The adjutant forms the line for battle. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the marching on of the colors and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem. As a kind reminder, for those wearing civilian headgear, please remove them and place them over your heart during the playing of the national anthem. And for those without civilian headgear, please place your right hand over your heart. ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
in command, officer center. All unit commanders and guidon bearers march to the front and center of the formation and salute the commander of troops. Historically, it was at this point the commanding officer would issue orders and instructions to the unit commanders. It also afforded the commander an opportunity to give his officers any last-minute encouragement prior to battle. Following this, the unit commanders would face about and return to their units and pass the information on to their Marines. Ladies and gentlemen, now taking his place in the reviewing area is the outgoing commander for America's Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Jonathan C. Goff. Ladies and gentlemen, now taking his place in the reviewing area is the incoming commander for America's Battalion, Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey C. Holt.
Sergeant Major, deliver the colors to the commanding officer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we now come to the ceremony's most solemn moment, the actual passing of command. The battle colors of a Marine Corps unit symbolize the authority and accountability of command. Transferring the colors during the ceremony symbolized the relinquishing of command by Lieutenant Colonel Goff. By accepting the colors, Lieutenant Colonel Holt accepts command and confirms his total commitment to the Marines and sailors that he will command. Sergeant Major Baldwin is delivering the colors to the commanding officer. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the transfer of the colors. From Commandant of the Marine Corps to Lieutenant Colonel Jonathan C. Goff, subject, relinquishment of command, effective 11 December 2009, you are directed to detach from 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines, and report to the commanding officer, 3rd Marine Regiment for duty. Signed, James T. Conway, Commandant of the Marine Corps. From Commandant of the Marine Corps to Lieutenant Colonel Jeffrey C. Holt, subject, assumption of command, effective 11 December 2009, you are directed to report to 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines for duty as commanding officer. Signed, James T. Conway, Commandant of the Marine Corps. Please be seated. Colonel Select Goff, I'd like to take this opportunity to extend my congratulations on a successful tour as the commanding officer of the 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marine Regiment, 3rd Marine Division. I know it has been both rewarding and challenging, especially through the PTP, the combat deployment, and most importantly, the separation from family. As you relinquish command today in front of family and friends, I wish you and Carmen the very best. Thank you for doing a terrific job out here, and I know you will have continued success in your new assignment as a Japanese Far East expert at PACOM. My Marines and sailors have certainly benefited from your leadership. Good luck and God bless. Semper Fidelis, James B. Laster, Brigadier General, United States Marine Corps, Commanding General, 3rd Marine Division. Dear Lieutenant Colonel Holt, congratulations on your selection as Commander, 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines, 3rd Marine Division. This significant career milestone is a fitting testimony to your proven leadership, achieved through hard work, dedication, and professionalism. I know you will lead the command to new heights. Please accept Roma and my very best wishes as you pursue the new challenges and opportunities that being a commander offer. Congratulations and best wishes to you and Stacy. Semper Fidelis, James B. Laster, Brigadier General, United States Marine Corps, Commanding General, 3rd Marine Division. Now receiving lei and coins on behalf of the Marines and Sailors of America's Battalion are the Goff family. As you were.
That's fine. That's fine. And what you're going to do?
I'm going to go here and then here.
Got to go to Colonel Bierman. Okay. Do we only have one fucking mic?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Gentlemen, the Regiment Commander, Colonel James Bierman. Go ahead.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, the Regimental Commander, Colonel James Bierman.
Morning, sir.
Good morning to everybody. Colonel Rice, Colonel Malavet, Commander Urbano, commanders, sergeants major, Marines and sailors, family members and guests, great to see you here. I also in particular, I'm looking around for, but I want to single out for acknowledgement Mrs. Mildred Courtney, a great lady whose kindness and generosity the entire regiment has benefited from now for many years. Mildred, it's great to have you here. I won't make the mistake I made last week. I want to make sure I thank the members of the Marfor Pack Band for another really fine performance. Well done. In the same way I did last week with 2-3, I want to start my comments by acknowledging the young Marines and sailors on the field in front of you today. The men of 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines, America's Battalion. Because this is their day. 3-3 is one of very few battalions in the Marine Corps, and most of the rest are in 3rd Marines, that for 5 years now have moved through one-to-one combat rotations. For every 7 months in garrison, they've spent 7 months in combat. Like the other units of 3rd Marines, the men of 3-3 have drawn some of the toughest assignments, and in fact, for most of the last 5 years, they've led the way in 3rd Marines. They were the first battalion in the regiment to deploy to the mountains of northeast Afghanistan, then followed by 2-3 and 1-3. They were the first battalion from the regiment to deploy to the mean streets of Haditha, followed then by 2-3 and 1-3, and they were the first battalion in the regiment to deploy to Carmen, followed by the other battalions of the regiment. And in every case, they got the job done. As noteworthy as those deployments and those accomplishments are, I have to say that I'm particularly proud of what these men, of what 3-3 has accomplished over the last year, specifically what 3-3 did in Western Iraq as task force MP. In the task force MP job, the Marines you see here, it was their responsibility to guard and secure the lines of communications and the convoys that were traveling back and forth that were vital to our effort across that great expanse of Western Iraq, and also to guard key sites. It was not a traditional mission for a Marine battalion, but 3-3 showed their versatility and their professionalism in getting the job done. In fact, for a lot of the time they were deployed, their time in Iraq came during a period where we were drawing down our presence in Iraq. So I would say, and I know the Marines in the crowd know exactly what I'm talking about, it was a particularly dangerous and challenging period, because only those units with the best discipline and focus and professionalism could have gotten through that period without giving in to complacency. And the men of 3-3 kept their heads throughout. In fact, these guys gained a reputation throughout all of M&F West and with 2MF as the go-to battalion, the battalion that was the glue that held the entire MF together. They sought out jobs. They advertised it. They did windows, and they performed superbly. One thing, one example I would give, and I know the members of the regiment know I'm particularly proud of this, is the recovery of the remains of Captain Scott Spiker. And that was a young Navy pilot, a young warrior who was killed on the first day of the Gulf War. For 18 years, dozens of specialized teams have moved through the deserts of Western Iraq, trying to find his remains to return him to his family, and they were all unsuccessful. 3-3 found him, and they found him because of just good old-fashioned Marine Corps grit and determination. And in my mind, it's an incredible story which hasn't been told enough. Because these guys are members of 3rd Marines, they're facing more of the same in their immediate future. They just got back from Iraq, but the clock's already ticking, and they've already begun their preparations to return to Afghanistan. No doubt in my mind whatsoever, under the leadership of Lieutenant Colonel Holt and Sergeant Major Cece, that we'll continue to see the same superb results from 3-3 in combat in Afghanistan. But if you would, please again stand and join me in a round of applause for these young guys out there today in America's battalion. Thank you. And now our lieutenant colonels. Some of you may not know, some of you do. I first met Lieutenant Colonel Chris Goff 25 years ago. I was a class ahead of him at the Virginia Military Institute. More specifically, we were in the same company, and more specifically, I was his corporal when he was a freshman. I will tell you that even in those days, Chris Goff was a standout. He always knew his rat knowledge. He always had those gleaming mirror spit shine shoes. And on top of it, and this particularly angered me, he had a 3.8 GPA. So he was very squared away. VMI being VMI, that didn't ever for one second stop me from applying the wire brush. But Chris was a very squared away freshman, and I would say Chris Goff is still a standout. In my view, you know, looking back over the last year and a half, looking at 3-3, he's been the consummate battalion commander. He formed a very admirable and appropriate partnership with Sergeant Major Baldwin. And the example of their mutual respect and friendship and their tight approach to the challenges laid in front of 3-3 set an example throughout the entire battalion. I would say Chris Goff is still a man who holds himself to high standards, and certainly he held 3-3 to high standards during the time he was there. Certainly for the 9 months I've been here, whether you're talking liberty incidents or readiness or training stats or maintenance, you know, 3-3 is one of very few battalions in the 3rd Marine Division to beat. I would say, you know, the old expression is, when a commander looks in the mirror, after 6 months in command, he's going to see himself, all his good traits and all his bad traits. And I believe the man out there today, 3-3, is a reflection of Lieutenant Colonel Chris Goff. And the battalion that's being handed over today is a good old-fashioned Marine battalion that's brilliant at the basics, that's proud of itself, and that is truly dedicated. And that's as a result of Chris Goff's exemplary efforts. Carmen, you've been amazing. All the time while Chris was deployed, it seemed like I'd look out there and I'd see you and Jenna, you know, riding around in the 4x4 off doing some good deed or preparing for some function. And I think the tight, proud way this battalion is, without a shadow of a doubt, has a lot to do with your efforts. And it's been remarkable to see, and thank you very, very much. Lieutenant Colonel Jeff Holt, I can't think of anybody whose particularly recent career path has better prepared him for battalion command. Jeff was the executive officer of 1-3, and he deployed with 1-3 to combat in Iraq. He was the operations officer for the regiment, and he deployed with the regiment to combat in Afghanistan. I would say I have no doubt whatsoever about Jeff's ability to lead a battalion in combat, because really I've seen it. During the time Jeff served as my XO in 1-3, we were in Haditha, and at that time 1-3 was a very large battalion task force, 9 companies. We were split right down the middle by the Haditha River, but all the bridges had been destroyed, so to get to the other side of the river, it was about 2 hours up the road, crossover, and 2 hours down, so very disconnected. Based off that, I made the decision to place Jeff in command of the units east of the river, which was 3 Marine companies and an Iraqi company, and a top-notch job. Whether planning raids to go out and get the Al-Qaeda guys in the deep desert, or meeting with the sheikhs, or traveling around the battlefield, making an impression on the young Marines, he did everything that needed to be done. And Jeff, I know you're ready, and I'm very confident in the results we're going to get from you and Sergeant Major CC. Congratulations. Stacy, I don't dare say welcome to the regiment, because at this point, I don't know, maybe Treat. I there's probably just a handful of wives who have been here longer, but not many. So I'll just say we're very, very glad to have you. You know how I feel about you, and congratulations. Thank you.
Sir, thank you for those kind remarks, and thank you for honoring the Marines and Sailors of America's Battalion. Welcome, sir, and to Beth, welcome. Colonel and Mrs. Rice, Colonel Malavette, Commodore Urbano, Captain Mrs. McAlexander, Colonel Bates, Master Gunnery Sergeant Mrs. Talmadge, Mrs. Mildred Courtney, Mrs. Evelyn Galliai, Mr. and Mrs. Lucan, Gold Star parents, thank you for being here today. And we honor your son. We're just very pleased that you could come today, and thank you for your presence here. Colonels, captains, sergeants major, fellow commanders, family, friends, and honored guests, Marines and sailors, welcome and thank you for coming out today. This is the season. It's not only the Christmas season, but the change of command season. And you're getting a workout just coming back and forth from Dewey Square. So I really appreciate you coming out today. Thank you. There's so many thank yous. Please bear with me, but, and I know I'm going to forget somebody. That's my greatest fear. But just a lot of people I like to thank. And the stack is of cards is thin. You're probably looking at that as I walked up here. How thick are his notes? Not too bad. Colonel Bierman, sir, you gave our history. I can tell you, you were an early influence on my life. There's a handful of guys I remember from those days when you're bald-headed and being shuffled to and fro, and seems like it's all a blur. But you're definitely one of them. And how could I forget as you kicked my door open on Sunday morning at 5:30 more than once? So you made quite an impression in more ways than one. But, sir, you did teach me a lot back then, and you're still mentoring me today, so I appreciate it. Thank you, sir. Colonel Rice, sir, thank you for your support. And at the same time, I'd like to thank your entire base command staff and all the people that work on this base and serve these Marines that you see before you here. I like change of commands. They're hard work for these guys, mostly. These guys worked way longer than I did on this. And thank you to them and to the band for being here. But I like it because we get to show off our Marines a little bit. And we all get to look at the reason that we wake up every morning and that we come to come in, or the reason we deploy, or the reason we do anything here because of these guys. And so it's a particularly proud moment that we can stand out here in front of you today. Thank you for your support, whether it's, and again, I'm going to forget somebody, but the Education Office, MCCS, there's just so many agencies on this base. And if you don't know it, if this is your first time, first tour in the Marine Corps, let me tell you right now, it doesn't get any better than this. I don't know what life was like in the 50s and 60s. My father and uncle were in the Marine Corps back in World War II, but this must have been what it's like. Small community, people know each other, people take care of each other. I can't believe the good fortune. We live, 200 meters from the Holts. We got to shut our doors so you probably don't hear me scream at the kids, but we're all right there together, and it's just a great community. And sir, you know, that you're the, and your staff are the reason that you're holding it all together. We appreciate it, sir. Colonel Malavette, sir, thank you for your support, and we enjoyed working with your Marines. Got to do that last year at PTA a little bit, and really enjoyed it. We don't get to do a couple of things we don't get to do too often. That's get on ships and work with our brothers in the MAG. And so we very much enjoyed working with you and your Marines, sir, and the exercise last year. Thank you, sir. And thank you in advance for, I know we're going to jump back in it with PTA. So thank you very much, sir. Chaplain and Mrs. Alexander, you've both been there for our Marines. Every time plane comes in, getting ready, preparations, we can't find something, we run out of something, we need something, a Marine needs help, and you're both there. And I just can't thank you enough for that. Mrs. Courtney, thank you also for your support for our Marines. I got emails in Iraq that talked about the things you were doing for our Marines. We appreciate it. So thank you very much. And also like to thank Dog Barney Productions. They're all the time for us, recording for posterity, what we're doing. Thank you very much for everything. And again, I'm not leaving, so I'll see you again many times. I look forward to it. Again, at the risk of being long-winded, I can't hesitate to, I don't want to, you know, not recognize my staff. I told my staff this the other day, I've told my wife this many times and other people, you know, when you take command, you think to yourself, holy cow, what am I getting into? What kind of people am I going to be with? They're all Marines, but you're just wondering, what's the proficiency? What, you know, and I can tell you right now, I've come home more than once shaking my head. I can't believe what a wonderful staff I had and what wonderful commanders and across the board. To a man, they are, I could go for an hour on each one of them. Special thanks to my Sergeant Major, our Sergeant Major. You know, he I don't know what else to say. What you said, sir, I can't top that. We had a bond. We're a team. I respect the heck out of him. He taught me a lot. And Sergeant Major Baldwin is a guy that is tactically proficient, technically proficient, proficient in maintenance. When he goes up to a 50 cal and tells you that something's not right with the range card or whatever, you can believe it, or any other weapon system in the battalion. And so he was out there with me offering tactical advice and teaching and training Marines. Not just sitting back, but out teaching and training Marines how to do their jobs and how to perfect their tactical art. And you just can't ask for a better guy than that. And somebody that'll come in, shut the hatch, and say, yeah, Sergeant Major, have a seat. I'm not sitting down, sir. We're going to have a talk. And I appreciate those times, too, because that's definitely, you know, the king needs to know when he doesn't have any clothes on. And it seems I was naked a lot, but I appreciate you for pointing that out, Sergeant Major. My XO, Seth Yost, I don't know what else to say. You've been a friend, a confidant, and not an XO. You've been a second in command, and I mean that. The guy that I could take off and entrust the battalion to and know that things were in good hands and go out to Waleed, Trabeel, or wherever and know that if something happens, when it happens, it seemed like it was a matter of when. If In fact, you told me one time, don't go, sir, because when you leave, something's going to happen. And it seemed like every time, but you handled it. You handled all of it. And a special thanks to Jana Baldwin and to Billy Joe for being such good friends and taking care of my wife. Major Eric Hamster, my OPSO, another guy. Looking forward to, he's a commander of troops today, but he's not going anywhere, and I can't wait to spend more time with him. Him and Seth, just a fantastic operations officer. A guy that I had to watch myself because it was so easy not to just kind of lose, just not pay attention, because Eric was in there pretty much 20 out of the 24 hours of a day. You could find Eric Hamstra working hard, and I'd have to make him go eat at times. Lieutenant Mathurin, my S1, my adjutant, thank you. Captain Stanley, RS2, thank you. Captain Gorsuch, RS4, our logistics officer and my Ranger buddy. Thanks for everything, and I look forward to seeing more of you and listening to more of your lies and stories that are always enjoyable. Lieutenant Cap has gone on to the regiment as well, our communications officer. They sent Lieutenant Cap checked in. He was a second lieutenant, and I heard he was coming, and I said, oh boy, we're in trouble. We got a second lieutenant. They don't, and most comm officers have told me, they don't teach you what you need to know in comm school. You learn it out here. Just so happens, Lieutenant Cap was a former staff sergeant, and a guy that had been in comm and knew what he was doing. And he, boy, he turned my logic on its ear with his proficiency and his leadership. More important, that's a big platoon over there. And that guy's a real leader, and I thank him. Lieutenant Latost, my supply officer, you see the band here today, and you see that I'm not in jail. We're not having this ceremony down at the brig, and a lot of that's due to you. So I appreciate it. Treat that guy good, Jeff, because I'm telling you what. Gunner Law, the best gunner in the Marine Corps. No offense, Gunner Harris, but I just love that guy. And Kevin Quigley, our battalion energizer bunny. If you want something done, you give it to the NBC officer, Kevin Quigley, and he's going to get it done, and it's going to be better than you ever thought it was going to be. Chaplain Martin, thanks for everything you've done for us. Thanks for being my friend. Thanks for being my chaplain. And thanks for ministering to the needs of our battalion. Thank you very much. And I look forward to seeing more of all of you. To my commanders, Captain Heil, and a special thanks to his wife, Sally, India Company Commander. And again, we've had some replacements, so forgive me, but I'm mentioning the team here that we went downrange with. Captain Hunt, John Hunt, Captain Damon Torres, the newest papa on this base. He just had a baby, so he's not here with us today. Captain Pernado and Major Hansen, and a special welcome to Captain Belcher, who just joined us, and Captain Zavala, who couldn't be here today. To my first sergeants, something the Sergeant Major and I used to talk about, what a great group of men. Every one of them, fantastic. Worked well together. Every one of them an example of leadership. Every one of them had their heads on straight, and every one of them helped me get my head on straight too many times. I appreciate it, and one of them is a Sergeant Major now. So Sergeant Major Houston, congratulations again. And most of all, these Marines. I spoke to these Marines this morning in private, and I'm not going to go over that again, but I'm literally at a loss for words of what to say, how wonderful this battalion is, every aspect of it, from our cooks to our riflemen to our squad leaders, most of whom are not sergeants, but are lance corporals and young Marines doing the job, sometimes two grades above their pay grade. They're wonderful men. They joined the Marine Corps in a time of war, knowing what they're getting into. I kind of got shanghaied. You know, I was already in, so I didn't have a choice. These guys joined knowing exactly what they're getting into. And how many men in America can say that today? Not too many. How many men in America can stand here where they're standing today? Not many. Very, very few. I'm getting towards the end. We're getting there. To my family, to my kids, first of all, we've drug you around the world, four overseas moves in 5 years. You know you've carted your kids too many places when about the same time in the spring they come up and they say, hey, when are we packing out, Dad? Every year, hey, not this year, guys, and not in the next couple years. So I'm glad we can be in one place for a change. To my wife and my best friend, I told you I wouldn't say too much because I don't think I can, and I certainly can't do justice to who you are and what you've done. Thank you very much, and I love you. To to the good Lord above, who listened to too many of my prayers. I'm here by design. This is something I wished for a long time, many years of praying, many years of asking. He put me here at the time. You know, I've been praying for a long time, but I wouldn't have got to come here if he'd answered the first prayer I sent out. And he made me wait a while. And as always, his solution is a lot better than mine. But I can't believe my good blessings and fortune to be here, where I started off in 2nd Battalion, 3rd Marines as a lieutenant, where we started off. It's great to be here and great to stay here for a while. Jeff and Stacy, it's been great the last few weeks. Through the changes of commands, the limo rides, and certain other things I probably should just keep quiet about. It's been great, and we just live down the street from each other, and it's going to be nice having more fun times. We look forward to it. I just can't believe the good fortune of this battalion. Sir, you said it all. No one could be more qualified than Jeff Holt, and I'll just stop there. I don't want to embarrass him, but I look forward to learning more from you in the future. This battalion's greatly blessed to have you. And Stacy, your qualifications and the things you do and know, and you've taught our Marines Lynx, our wives Lynx classes. You've been involved with 3-3 already, and we thank you for that and welcome you. God bless everybody here. God bless America's battalion. You're going in harm's way, and they're going to win, just like 1-3 is over there winning right now and 2-3 before them. That's one thing we can count on. And I'll be praying for you. I'll be watching what you're doing, and I'll be thinking about you. Semper Fidelis, fair winds and following seas.
Well, as the last speaker for today, you've got to be brief, especially as an incoming guy. That's why I have one note card, and it has one word, and it says wife. So don't forget the wife. First of all, I want to thank God for the opportunity just to be here today amongst you and for the great weather. Next, I need to thank the band, because that was probably the coolest sound off I have ever heard. I appreciate that. For some of our guests today, Colonel Bierman, I want to thank you for just this opportunity and leadership. And your continued leadership you're going to give me throughout the rest of the time here in Hawaii. It's always been meaningful and special to me, so I thank you for being you. For Colonel Malavet and the rest of the Hawaii MAGTAF team, it's truly unique, and I'm very blessed for that. So I thank you for everything you've done for our regiment and will continue to do. And for Colonel Rice and the base and all the support and the great men that you have that do support us, I thank you for that especially. For Captain Urbano and all the P3 demonstrations you give to my son, I appreciate that. And he loves the air shows. For my fellow commanders that I've gotten to know, thank you for coming today, and especially the staff of the regiment, who I've gotten to know so well over my few years, 2 years as an OPSO, which I was truly blessed. And I thank for all the opportunities I've had as an XO and as an OPSO of this regiment to make me prepare for today. I feel three things. One, I'm excited. I'm happy. Two, I'm very humble to be given this opportunity to command America's battalion. And three, I'm ready. To the special guests that we have here today, I don't want to echo everything that Lieutenant Colonel Goff said, but for Miss Evelyn and Miss Courtney, Lieutenant Colonel Bates, and Mr. Brent, I want to thank you for coming out today. Your continued support is special. And we're truly honored here to have the Leakins. As a 3-3 will always be their home. And we thank you guys for coming all the way out from 19 degree weather to be here in sunny Hawaii. That's great. To the Goffs, Chris and Carmen, you guys have given us probably the best turnover a man could ever ask for. I mean, truly, everything you did to prepare this battalion, and I'll speak about that in a moment, was incredible. And your professionalism and what you gave and what you achieved with this battalion is remarkable. And I'm going to go into that in a little bit, the accomplishments. To my wife, I could ask for no better wife, no better spouse, no better partner, and truly invested in what I do, and knowledgeable. So it's great. She's also a member of the Marine Corps Family Team Building group that's in the back, and I'm very lucky for that, and I love you. For my family who came out from Texas and Georgia, I think,
I appreciate it. My mom and dad, to my sisters, Renee and Cheryl, and Michael and Scott, Major Benson, thank you for coming out. And Jenny, thank you too. Over to 3-3. The accomplishments were spoken already about this great battalion, the America's Battalion. Task Force MP to the three border missions. She got some unique missions from personnel recovery. But what I want to speak to and key in on is what you did to get ready for the next deployment, because that is amazing. 200 MRAP drivers trained alone. Done already. Don't have to do it. Thanks to their foresight and organizational skill, that's already done for me. That is huge, considering we have a one-to-one PTP. I've got a Christmas break coming up and leave that we will honor for you. And three key exercises to get us ready. We don't have time to make drivers, and you did that for me. You also did TSC classes, so we're ready to do site exploitation. That takes a lot to do that while you're already in combat, let alone you got everyone upgraded in Marine Corps martial arts a belt. I don't know where you found time to do it with all the recovery missions and then the Task Force MP, let alone opening up every quad con or PAL con or container that was on Al-Asad. As you know, we're retrograding OIF to go into OEF. They moved and retrograded $53 million worth of equipment. I can't even tell you the number of pieces, but that was a significant amount of work they had to do. Okay, my drum beat, my constant drum beat is three things for this battalion. And Chris, I thank you for everything you did to get us ready before I move on. The constant drum beat I have for America's Battalion is one, work hard. Two, have fun. And three, be safe. That's my command philosophy, and it has been since I was a lieutenant, and it will remain today as a lieutenant colonel. And we'll talk more about that today when I speak to you in detail. The road ahead is a PTP, which is the one-to-one dwell, the Viper series of exercises. Will be challenging. We're in one right now. This week alone, they're doing an exercise. It's here local. It's the Island Viper exercise. It's a couple weeks. They also moved barracks to make rooms for others. And third, they did change of command practice. Can you imagine those three large events in 1 week and what it's asked of these men? They put on such a great parade so far, and I really appreciate that. So the road ahead will be a PTP with two more exercises. We will go to Pohakalua training area on the Big Island of Hawaii, and then off to Mojave Viper. We have an early Mojave Viper in our schedule, and that will prepare us, and we will be ready to be an infantry battalion conducting counterinsurgency operations in Afghanistan in the spring. And for that, I look forward, and I am honored to be your battalion commander of what is to be the best battalion, if not already, in the Marine Corps, America's Battalion. So for those that have come today, I thank you for your attendance. We do have some refreshments out back. And God bless and Semper Fi.
Now receiving lay on behalf of the Marines and Sailors of 3rd Battalion, 3rd Marines, are the Holt family. Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, please rise as the colors approach your direct front. The battalion staff, led by the commander of troops, Major Eric Hamstra. The conductor for the Mar 4-Pack Band for today's ceremony is Staff Sergeant Rob Roman. The company commander for Headquarters and Service Company is Major Jason Hansen. The platoon commander for 1st Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Elon Greenberg. Platoon commander for 2nd Platoon is 1st Lieutenant Andrew McCullough. Commander for 3rd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Michael Barnum.
Right.
The company commander for Weapons Company is Captain John Hunt.
Right.
The platoon commander for 1st Platoon is 1st Lieutenant Christopher Luger. The platoon commander for 2nd Platoon is 1st Lieutenant Jim Wang. Platoon commander for 3rd Platoon is 1st Lieutenant Joshua Roberts. The battalion color sergeant is Sergeant Justin Gurley. The commander for Company I is 1st Lieutenant Michael Cornell. The platoon commander for 1st Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Jason Stokes. The platoon commander for 2nd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Garrett Johnson. Platoon commander for 3rd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Tyler Tebow. The company commander for Company K is Captain Sean Belcher. Platoon commander for 1st Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Scott Fleming. The platoon commander for 2nd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Clark Smith. Company commander for Company L is Captain Luke Pernato. Platoon commander for 1st Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Seth Miller. The platoon commander for 2nd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Mark Bodrog. Platoon commander for 3rd Platoon is 2nd Lieutenant Bradley Franco.